Hi, I'm Kim. Welcome to Chatterbox Quilts. I wanted to show you this little light board that I recently got because I like to do fusible web applique, and so you have to trace your applique design onto fusible web, and it's always easier when you have a light source behind it. Now, I often find I can just put it down on my cutting table and I can see through the fusible web usually, or I can use a window, but that doesn't work very well at nighttime when there's no sun out. So I thought, time to bite the bullet, time to get a little light table here. So what I picked up is this one here. They call it a light pad, actually. It's an LED light pad. This is from Huion, I think is how you pronounce it, H-U-I-O-N. And I'll put a link in the description below so you can see which particular one I'm talking about. This is actually the L4S model. There are different ones you can get. This particular one, you need to be able to plug it into your laptop. You plug it into the USB port on your laptop. Your laptop doesn't have to be plugged in, but it does have to be there, or you're not going to be able to use the little light pad. It's really lightweight, and it's really thin. I couldn't believe it. It feels like picking up just a few sheets of cardstock, for example. And it's kind of cool because it has a dimmable feature as well. So if I don't need it quite as bright, I can dim it down a bit. So to use it, after I've plugged it into my computer, of course, I can just press on here, and the longer I hold it, the brighter it gets. So that's about as bright as it's going to get, which is pretty bright. So I'm using my Hearts Abloom pattern right now just to show you how I would trace onto my fusible web. So I take my pattern piece, my applique pieces I want to trace, I put them on the light table. I have a sheet of steamacine right now, and I put over top. So you can see I could trace very easily. I can see all those things quite easily, all the different shapes. And if I wanted to do, say, needle turn applique, and I wanted to trace these pieces onto fusible web, onto freezer paper, you can see that I can see through the freezer paper as well. You might want to use this if you were doing wool applique, for example. You would trace your shapes onto the freezer paper first, and then that would go onto your wool and you could cut them out. So I can see both of them really, really well. So this is going to be really handy, I can tell already. And if I want to have it dim, I'm just holding on the little space here and it'll eventually come up and it'll go down. So it's kind of fun just to play around with a bit. And then it's just off like that. So easy to store. It came in a little sleeve, just a little plastic kind of sleeve, but I might put it back in there just to protect the surface. And, you know, it's not very big at all. It's got little cushions on the back sort of to put it on your surface. It's going to hold it in place, not too badly. This is a fairly slippery surface, but it's not going to run away when you start tracing, that's for sure. So if you're interested in getting one of these for yourself, if you haven't gotten one yet, I can recommend this particular one. There is one with a rechargeable battery. I did not get that one because it's quite a bit more money, and I thought this will work just fine for as often as I need to use it. So if you liked this video, and I hope you did, please hit the like button below the video and subscribe if you haven't already done so, so you'll get new notifications when new videos are being released each and every week from Chatterbox Quilts. Thanks for watching.